Saturday, everybody. We had some patchy fog this morning in our south and eastern counties that should be lifting by around 8 o'clock this morning. And then earlier today, we also had some heavier downpours in parts of Holmes and Itala County. Some thunderstorm activity now making its way into Grenada, Eupora, and Shelby around 7 o'clock this morning. Temperatures started off in the mid to low 70s, and we will slowly warm on up into the 80s, but it'll be around the middle to later part of the morning until that actually happens. Clouds are already in the mix this morning. Some nice sunshine on our South Jackson Skycam. Those clouds will increase, though, as we head through the later part of the morning and into the afternoon hours. Highs will range between 88 to 91 in the metro, 89 expected with an afternoon shower or thunderstorm possible. And then as we head into the evening hours, we're going to keep the clouds around. Mostly cloudy skies to wake on up. Temperature 73, 86 for tomorrow with rain and storm chances picking on up. So here's this hour by hour forecast for you for the weekend. Again, not everybody is going to see rain today, but everybody has a shot of seeing an afternoon shower or a thunderstorm. These rain chances clear on out shortly after sunset. And as we head into tomorrow morning, most of us staying dry. Wouldn't be shocked if we have a stray shower in the morning hours, but those best chance of rain and storms really pick on up as we head into the heat of the day. We have several things happening over the next several days. We have a cold front that's going to stall, a low pressure over into New Mexico and Arizona that will push eastward and rise along the stalled boundary. That's going to increase our moisture, and a tropical system in the Gulf of Mexico that too also going to increase our moisture and rain content for this upcoming week. So expect that soggy pattern to continue as we go into the week ahead. As of the 7 o'clock advisory, still no tropical depression or tropical storm Danielle, but it is very much possible we can see one or the either as we head into the later part of the day today. As of the 7 o'clock advisory, it does show it's strengthening briefly to a tropical storm. So this would be tropical storm Danielle before making landfall late this evening just south of Harlingen and Brownsville, Texas. But when that moves on in, we're looking at heavy rain and flooding potential over towards Texas and Louisiana. This plus, like I said, the low pressure from New Mexico and Arizona and that stalled boundary is going to bring the early part of the week almost a complete washout for Monday, even into Tuesday. We could have a brief break overnight, but even then we are looking at heavy rain possible and a few thunderstorms. The best total for rain, I guess you could really call it best, the greatest total is going to be back off towards Texas, 2 to 5, maybe even up to 7 inches of rain possible in isolated places. Over towards Mississippi, we're looking at around 2 to 3 inches of rain. But if you are susceptible to flash flooding, especially west of 555, you really need to keep track of this 7-day forecast for you. Temperatures are going to be staying well below average by Monday. The record for the coolest high on record is 75 degrees. Obviously, we're not going to get that, but we could get into the top 5 coolest highs on record. We'll eventually warm on up into the upper 80s by the end of the week, and then guidance is a little divided. Some showing a drier week into the week, others showing a little bit on the soggier side. I do think we'll have the chance for an afternoon shower or thunderstorm, but as we go into next week, we'll start to track what Friday night lights could look like.